Hi, welcome to week 4. Today we will start the central part of our course. In fact, we will start considering the ways in which we can compute the probability of default of a counterparty. But we will also consider tools that we can use in our everyday life if we decide to invest in bonds or other securities. Are you ready? So, let's start. We want to determine the probability of default of our counterparty. There are different tools that we can use for this purpose. Simplifying a little bit, we can make use of tools belonging to two important classes, ratings and default models. Within the ratings class, we can make a distinction between external and internal ratings. Let's assume we are all part of a big international bank. External ratings are ratings, credit ratings to be more precise, that we obtain from third parties, typically rating agencies such as Moody's, Fitch, and Standard & Poor's. We pay a fee and we obtain all the information we need. As we will see, external ratings are only available for certain clients, usually large corporate clients. This is why, as a bank, we can also make use of internal ratings, which we obtain using internal proprietary methods. If we consider the other class, the one of default models, we can make a clear distinction between structural and non-structural models of default. A structural model of default is a model in which default happens when the assets of a company reach a sufficiently low level with respect to liabilities. This family of models include some of the most important models in credit risk management, such as Merton's model and proprietary models like Moody's KMV and JP Morgan's credit metrics. Non-structural models of default include mixture models and other rather sophisticated approaches. In this case, we will briefly consider Credit Risk Plus by Credit Suisse. It is worth noticing that the great majority of methods and models we will consider belong to the internal rating-based approach of Basel II and III. Naturally, we can distinguish between the foundation and the advanced approaches, but we will come back to this later on, at the end of these 3 weeks. Always speaking about PDs, we will also deal with some tools like CDS and credit spreads, and we will see how we can use them to estimate the probability of default of a counterparty. These notions will be very useful every time we decide to invest in a bond or any other security, which implies some credit risk. This is a summary of what we are going to see together. This scheme is very important to have a clear idea of what we are going to do in the next weeks, and, most of all, the reasons why. I strongly suggest you to print it out from the slides, which, as usual, are available for download.
Okay, the overview is over. We can finally start our journey. See you next time. Ciao!